Here you go, you fucking dogs. Tonight we're hitting some chest at the gym. The weather's looking like a sack of monkey shit at the moment. It's fucking cold, it's raining, it's windy, but that ain't stopping us from going to the gym. Not gonna lie, I had the fucking fattest nap after work today. I literally fucking rose out of a coma. Smacked down some steak and chips, which I forgot to show you, but oh well, I'll show you another time. And yeah, now it is time to fire up the killer cruise and get to the gym. So without further ado, let's get it. Shit! EHPlabs, code Wulff, you dogs. Now, this is the real question. One scoop or two? That's the question, you know? Man, are you kidding me right now? What, one scoop or two? Man, you really thought I was gonna do one scoop? Shit, man, you was a silly motherfucker, man. I don't give a fuck, it's 8 p.m. It's alright, I ain't got anywhere to be tomorrow morning. Shit, man, for real, for real. Alright. Let's fucking get it, mate, on the fucking road. What's on the radio? He tried to take me out. Shut up. Alright, like I said, come not drive without the glasses. That's fucking... I don't want to crash. Not yet, at least. Alright. So, how was your day? How you doing? Tell me in the comments below. Or not. I don't mind. But I hope you guys had a good fucking day, wherever you're from. This is to anybody out there, if you go to the gym with a friend, if you're getting started with a friend at the gym, and they stop coming and shit, and they're inconsistent, this is your reminder to keep motherfucking going. See, when I first started the gym, I had a gym buddy, and no shame to him, I love him, I love you, Johnny, but I ain't gonna lie, he was a bitch, and you know, we started going to the gyms in the mornings together. Hold up. Go, son! Go, 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 go! It's gonna blow up! Go on, son! I'm waiting till the day this fucker blows up, and that'd be cringe. That'd be so cringe if my car blew up. Anyway, I get so fucking distracted. Squirrel! But yeah, I had a gym buddy, and we'd go in the mornings, and you know, some mornings he'd wake up, and he wouldn't feel like going, and my fat ass was like, bruh, we gotta go, man. We gotta go. And I know sometimes it can be hard to go by yourself. What I did was I just taught myself the things I need to know. You know what I mean? Like you fucking just like by watching videos like this, I hope, or any other videos, like you can teach yourself the different exercises. And if you're scared of being by yourself in the gym, trust me, people are not focused on you in the gym. Everyone is focused on themselves. The only time people care about other people is when you're being like a loud ass motherfucker, or like you're doing something purposely to create attention. Do you know what I mean? So like if you're doing your thing, everyone's there to be a better person. You know what I mean? Like I keep saying, do you know what I mean, a lot. Fuck me. Do you know what I mean? I'm about to have a fit. When I first started in the gym and I was really chubby, you know, I kind of got pretty self-conscious about like other people looking at me. But then one day, I was in the middle of eating a double cheeseburger, right? And I was like, motherfucker, I am in the gym to make myself better. Do you, like, you feel me? Like, why would I be discouraged about what other people think of me when I'm literally doing what it takes to become a fucking aesthetic sick cunt? You know what I mean? And if you're doing what it takes, then who cares? You know what I mean? A lot of times, and sometimes at recess and lunch at school, I would literally like run laps at recess. I didn't do it for too long, but I'd run laps and people would just laugh at you. But I think part of that deep down is that people know that you're like, you're trying to change. People know that you're trying to do something for yourself and become better. So deep down, people kind of just throw shit at you to throw you off because they actually fear you. Do you feel me? Oh, I gotta remember to drink my magic drink too, because it takes time to sink into your body. That's a tip. Pre-workout and carbs, if you have them, take about half an hour to kick in. So usually you want to get down your drink or your pre-workout snack about 30 minutes, So then once you start lifting, the fucking, that's when it hits. If you're drinking it on the way to the gym like I am now, hop on the treadle for a bit, hop on the bike, hop on something, go in the change rooms and have a bat rub one out, I don't care. Just do something to pass a bit of time, to let it kick in. Yeah, because you don't want to be jumping into heavy set straight away, but where the fuck's the pretty not kicking in, mate? And it's like, bruv, it takes time for it to fucking sink into your blood, all right? Settle down. Anyway, that brings me to tonight's exercises on the agenda. I'm thinking a bit of, I like a lot of incline movements for chest, I'm not going to lie to you. So usually I mix it up between the incline dumbbells or the Smith machine. Either one is pretty cute, to be honest with you. I usually like doing dumbbells when I've got homies with me because it's spotting and whatnot. But then again, we did Smith machine the other night. So I reckon, no, we'll throw around some dumbbells tonight because the other night we did Smith machine and I don't want to bore you. We're going to mix it up, you feel me? So dumbbell incline press. Flies, really, I'm a slut, I'm a slut for some flies, you feel me? So I'm thinking some, I'm thinking seated cable flies, and also, there's like this incline press machine at my gym with that, you like, it's plate loaded, and yeah, that gets a pretty fucking filthy upper chest pump, and then maybe just to, for a finisher, maybe like one or two sets of pec deck. Just to really fucking get that good stretch. Yeah. But anyway, I am literally pulling up to the gym as we communicate. Fuck your park. Just took up two parks. But oh well. Alright, see you in there.
Alrighty. Just get warmed up. So yeah, when I hit incline dumbbell press, just like to start really light, work your way up. That way you don't injure yourself and your body adapts to the weight.
Alright, next weight, 22, take them for a spin. Random ass number, random ass weight to pick, but I'll fuck it.
Whew. The fucking button on my left fucking sleeve broke when I went out one night. It's really fucking pissing me off. I really like this shirt. Now my shirt's just fucking sparked. Sensational.
I was working on some merch concepts. I was gonna spend some money on getting some stock in to get some merch going, but had to buy a PT course, which I have been really lazy with, but I just got a new job, so hopefully my routine, gonna get a routine going so I have more time to study. Because I want to become a PT and I want to start helping train some of you guys, because I'll give advice. I'm not saying you should do exactly what I say. The credentials speak for himself. So it's up to you if you want to listen to me. But yeah, I want to get qualified so I can start taking on some of you dogs' clients. Would you work with this fella? I don't know. One more cheeky warm-up set and then we will start throwing around some bigger weights.
Full reps, lads. None of this fucking, a lot of times when people go heavy on dumbbell press, you see them going like, fucking like that. Nah, I can't. Drop the ego out the fucking door. Full reps. Full reps, boys. Anyway, but that's a warm up though for the heavy reps. We won't go too crazy, otherwise I'm gonna fucking already exhaust myself.
The biggest thing in the gym is form over your weight. Sure, everyone wants to fucking throw around some cool weight. But like, if you actually want to build quality muscle, you know, do a weight that's respectable. You know, it's not easy or anything, but fucking, you know, something you can actually get clean reps with. And then, like I said the other day, once you got your clean reps done, start really fucking swing it. I don't fucking know, cheat. Whatever you can till complete failure, you know? Is this Megan Thee Stallion or fucking Lizzo? They're like the same person. I don't fucking know.
When you're doing dumbbell incline press, especially when you're going heavier, it can be very hard to get into the starting position to get that first rep up. Because once after you got the first rep up, it's fucking chill, you know what I mean?
So getting into that first rep can be pretty difficult. So I'm going to explain to you quickly the easiest way to get into this position, right? So start with the dumbbells on your knees. And it's up to you whether you want to go straight for it. I usually like to rock a few times.
One, two, three. And then as you go back, as you lean back, kick both your legs up and you already have the weight in like the starting position type shit, you feel me? I'll show you what I mean, all right? Watch and learn, buddy. All right, ready? Three, two, one. Yep. See, I like kicked my fucking knees and then kind of like, yeah. Because otherwise, just taking the dumbbells off your knees, one, like, you're not doing that. Not at this weight, at least. Anyway. Ooh. Ooh. Yeah, buddy. Then. You know what's the worst? When you're done with your weights, fucking freaking out where my phone is. I'm filming. My phone's right fucking there, you know? Worst fear is dropping a fucking weight on my phone, which I've done before. But anyway. Quick drop set too. Fucking well. Just fucking good pump. Yeah. Buddy. Fucking. Oh, you fucking Sultana. Fuck, penguin. Oh, yowza lad. Another thing is when people do incline dumbbell press, some people will tell you to stop your arms at 90 degrees. Why the fuck would you stop there when you can go all the way down? Look how much more stretch you get. People say it's to avoid injury. Don't do it with a fucking heavyweight, you peanut. You know what I mean? Like if you're picking a respectable weight, you'll easily be able to go down and you won't injure yourself. You fuck. Of course you're gonna fuck. It's the same, the people that do those half reps are the same people to tell you to stop at 90 degrees. You know? Yeah, sure, you're gonna get fucking some muscle stimulus from doing that, but it's nothing in comparison to doing your full fucking reps with a respectable weight. Do you know what I mean? 100% get someone fucking do it that fucking half repping 60 saying shut the fuck up or some shit. I don't care. Ooh. Ooh, first rep, so as a dog. Ooh. Also, have that angle. Instead of being straight on like that, lads, have that angle on. Much more chest involvement, less strain on your shoulders, less chance of injury. Ooh. Fuck yeah.
You took something that didn't belong to you.
That's that. That is that. Fucking, I don't even know where to put these.
Ooh.
Just getting started. Fuck, yeah. Fuck. Ooh. Mummy. That's as good as you're gonna get it, mate. Ooh. I think we'll move on to some seated cable flies next, so I'll see you there. Like in between my sets, I've been drinking like fucking half a shaker at a time. Speaking of which, like a lot of people underestimate their water intake. The reality is that most of your muscles are made up of water. Water gets stored in the muscles, so the more water you have, the more weight you'll be able to push. If you're neglecting your water intake, you're not going to be able to push anywhere near as much weight as if you're actually drinking enough water. Which I can get pretty slack for. You also need to drink water if you want your creatine to work. If you don't drink any water and you're taking creatine, you're just pissing the creatine out, really. This set is the fucking pumpernickel, lad. Fucking tell you what. One set of this, one solid ass fucking set, and I feel like a fucking gorilla that escaped the fucking zoo, bruh. Here we go. Head up, chest up. arms flat like that. It's pretty much like a bench press, but instead of lying flat, you're upright. And a lot of people, some people like to do standing, but for me, seated is the go, because your body's stable. You're fully isolating your pectoral, going back and forth those steady reps. You really control and isolate your pec. Like, also the same with the pressing, instead of flat, angle that like that. Controlled and push. My chest has always been a massive lacking part in my physique, and ever since like doing these and all other incline movements, doing the exercises that I'm doing now has like fully brought them up to par. I'm not saying my chest is immaculate, but it's a lot better than when I first started, or at least literally the start of this year. My chest is probably the thing that's been brought up the most this year. I'm not even counting reps, I'm literally just yapping. No, that's it. Fuck. Oh. I hate slamming the weights, I'm not even meaning to, but when you've gone to complete failure, there is literally not a chance I'm going to be able to get up and fucking put him down nicely. I'm sorry, but it's just how it is. Anyway. Alright, here we go. What in the fuck is this music, man? So one thing I miss about when I film, I can't use headphones, but it's all good. I have to listen to this bullshit. But like I said, the voices are always fucking... The voices are doing their bit. When you bust and shorty keep sucking. Oh. Serious. Oh, here goes fucking nothing. Alright, next up we're going to do the incline plate-loaded press. I don't know what it's called, but I will see you there. How the fuck do you adjust this? Am I missing something? Well, quick drop set. Ooh. Come on. Really getting on. I feel like a frog that drank a whole bottle of whiskey in one go. I'm really feeling this. Tonight's rest between sets have been about five, nearly 10 minutes per, because I don't know why. I just get such a deep stretch in my chest. And like, yeah, I just need those minutes to recover. Otherwise, I'm giving a half-ass set. At the end of the day, as long as you are training to failure, no matter what weight, whether you're doing heavyweight or lightweight, if you're training to failure, you're going to grow. Some people prefer high volume. Compared to how I used to work out, doing like 1 minute rest sets, your body still feels that fatigue. So when you're entering another set, you can't give your full 110%. Say I do a set of this for 8 reps till complete failure, and then I rest 2 minutes and I do another set, I'm probably only going to get about 5 reps, really. But if I wait and recover 5-10 minutes, or until I'm fully recovered, until I feel fully ready, you know, I might get another 8 reps. Slow down your sets, recover, listen to your body, and you'll push more weight. Ooh. Ooh. Fuckery. Alright, same old, buddy. Whew. Let's go, let's get it. Joking. Gonna do one set to fuck around on the pec deck, and then yeah, we'll pose up. Also, with pec deck, I don't like to have my arms straight out like that. I like to bring them in a bit more. Chest contraction is a lot better, uses less of your shoulder, more pec focus. Get that real good squeeze. All right, a quick drop set. Quick droppity drop, 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 drop. Your body dropping. All right, let's get it. Imagining I'm trying to hug a Latina. She doesn't exist. Come on. Come on. Oh my god. Time to undo the flanny and see what bro's cooking. Not a bad pump at all. Fucking suppose I'll pack up my shit and I'll see you in the car. There we go. Whew. I'm looking pretty fucking soft at the moment, but it's alright when summer comes. Anyway. Hold up, listen to it. Ready? It sounds that shit, ready? Alright, let me fucking stick this out the window, cunt. It's fucking that shit. How many fucking hats in here? Alright, I'm gonna see if I've got any hats in my boot. Ugh. Fucking hell.
I look like I shouldn't be allowed near playgrounds when I wear this hat. But anyway. That was a pretty fucking good workout. I won't lie to you. I definitely could not be fucked tonight. Like, when I got home from work, I fucking passed out and had the fucking fattest nap, like I mentioned before. But yeah, overall, like, that's the thing. The workouts when you don't feel like going and then you get them done, you know what I mean? They're the ones where you really feel, like, fucking proud of yourself that you went and got it done. I'm taking off the hat now. Anyway. I'm still yet to feature my mates Max and Brody in the video. They've been pretty busy and stuff. But like I mentioned, I got a new job, so I'm going to be free during the mornings. So I'm going to have a lot more time and energy to start posting these vlogs consistently. I'm going to aim to start posting daily, because some of you guys in the comments have been saying that you fuck with the daily uploads. So at the moment, I've been trying every 2 days. But like I said, I've got a new routine going, so I should be good to film and edit every day. This type of content isn't too hard to edit. Just have to, it's pretty much just fishing through all the bullshit when I'm just yapping too much, like when my ADHD just takes over and I'm fucking starting to speak fluent Japanese, you feel me? That's the only reason why editing takes so long sometimes, because I literally just spit that much shit. It doesn't even make sense. So. But yeah, that's pretty much all said and done. So I think it's time to drive to a female's house to do some cardio. But until then, fuck the lot of you.